टुडे प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर मनोज कुमार विल गिव लेक्चर ऑन द टॉपिक ऑफ द कस्टमर रिलेशनशिप मैनेजमेंट, हाउ द कस्टमर रिलेशनशिप इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर दिस न्यू बिजनेस एरा, फॉर द कंपटीटिव एनवायरनमेंट. Why the customer relationship is important. A literature review and the future research direction. This paper is published in the International Journal Decision Sciences, Risk and Management, Volume 2, Number 1 to 2009. Customer relationship management can be seen as a scientific decision making system. A scientific decision making system will be there, incorporating methodology, software, and internet capability that can enable organization to focus on the customer needs and the further manage customer relationship in a systematic and holistic way. The complete definition of the customer relationship management have been given. This is a scientific decision-making system incorporating methodology. Methodology ko incorporate kijiye, software ko use kijiye, internet capability ko use kijiye to focus on the customer need. Customer needs ke base pe कस्टमर नीड को आइडेंटिफाई कीजिए, व्हाट आर द नीड ऑफ द कस्टमर, और उसके अकॉर्डिंग कस्टमर रिलेशनशिप बनाइए इन ए सिस्टमेटिक एंड द होलिस्टिक वे. हाउएवर द अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द सीआरएम कॉन्सेप्ट इज स्टिल इनकम्प्लीट एंड द ग्रोइंग एज एन इमर्जेंट फील्ड. कस्टमर CRM requires more time and study to clarify all its facets. The purpose of this paper is to enlighten some practical aspects of the CRM implementation. By critically reviewing the related literature, consideration is given to the key phases of the CRM implementation process. The three options for a CRM solution, the CRM project evaluation, the critical success factors for the CRM implementation, and the CRM perceived benefits. These all are discussed here in this paper. Some practical aspects of the CRM implementation, how the CRM implementation can be done. Key phases of the CRM implementation process, the options for a CRM solution, the CRM project evaluation, the critical success factors for the CRM implementation, and the CRM perceived benefits. Some future directions are also highlighted as regards CRM implementation. CRM implementation ke bare mein future research direction yahan par aapko diya hua hai. Keywords are the customer relationship management, CRM, decision making software system. What are the different decision making software systems are there? Business intelligence. What are the customer needs are there? Identifying the customer need. Customer chahta kya hai? What the customer wants. I have written many of the paper on the customer relationship management and book on the customer relationship, what the customer wants, and the customer loyalty, how to make a customer loyal, and now the introduction is there. Customer relationship management is an information industry term for the methodology, software, internet capability that help an enterprise manage the customer relationship in a systematic way. A company might build a database about its customer that depict relationship in sufficient detail so that the management, salespeople, people providing services, and occasionally the customer directly could assess information and match customer needs with products, plans, and offerings. Customer needs with the products, plans, and offerings. What the customer needs. CRM is seen as an all-embracing approach that seamlessly integrates the sales, customer service, marketing, field support, and other related functions, thereby maximizing the relationship with all customer, including the e-customer, distribution channel members, internal customers, and the suppliers. The maximizing the relationship with the customers, including the e-customer. What are the different type of the e-customers are there? Distribution channel members. What are the distribution channel members are there? Internal customers are there, and the suppliers. It explores an approach to maximize customer value through employing the company's understanding of the drivers of current and future customer profitability to appropriately allocate the resources across all areas that affect customer relationship, including the communication, customer service, billing and the collection, product service development, pricing strategy. What the pricing strategy will be there? This is important. Of the company will be there. This is the very important issue. And the how the product and service development will be there. How the service should be developed. This is an important issue. Basically, CRM dictates how an organization can increase the value of interaction to maximize the profit. How to maximize the profit? This is the main goal of any of the organization. CRM dictates that how an organization can increase the value of the interaction to maximize the profit, how the profit should be maximized. CRM, customer relationship management, has not always been the multifaceted software that so many organizations relied on today. During the 80 decade, companies began using the databases to track existing and the potential customer. This practice was known as the database marketing and entailed creating survey and holding the focus group. Many drawbacks existed with this particular method. Data collected through the surveys did not offer valuable information, as it could not be efficiently processed and analyzed. During the late 80s, the business world was introduced to contact management software, which allowed for the shortage and the organization of the customer contact information. During the late 80s, the business world was introduced to contact management software, which allowed for the storage and the organization of the customer contact information. While the first iteration were introduced in the 1980s, the concept did not become very popular until the 90s. The main reason was the explosion of the IT technology that enabled early CRM adopters to truly improve CRM software. The evolution was pushed by the innovator to a primitive version of the Salesforce automation software. Salesforce automation combined many of the features of its procedures to provide businesses with much more useful information. It was much more mature or useful information. The last half of the decade brought huge changes to the CRM industry as major vendors like Oracle, BandBall provided a fierce competition and moved the market towards a broader suite of the service. The term CRM started winning out as the most popular term for the front office application. The CRM system had now become dual. In that, company began to see the offering incentive to customer based on the tracking customer activity and identifying spending patterns. This was the beginning of now familiar frequent flyer program and bonus points on the credit cards. In the early 2000, the dot-com bubble burst and the CRM market contracted. A few years later, the CRM industry started coming of the age. Software company began releasing easier to use, more affordable and customizable solutions. CRM offered a way to dynamically enhance the understanding of the customer need and the behavior. Dynamically enhance the understanding of the customer need. How to understand the customer need and the behavior. Thanks to the internet, companies no longer had difficulty managing the vast amounts of the information constantly being fed in. And offsite storage become possible. Also, new strategy with the closer cooperation among the sales, customer service, and the marketing were developed through shared information and the understanding, leading to increased customer satisfaction from order to input. Today, the three business sectors that rely most heavily on the customer relationship management are the financial services, high technology corporation, and the telecommunication industry. The three business sectors that rely most heavily on the CRM are the financial services, high technology corporation, and the telecommunication industry. Despite this phenomenal evolution, the concept of the CRM is still incomplete and growing. Several reasonable definitions were provided through the years in an effort to encapsulate the meaning of this multidisciplinary term. Still, a lot of research needs to be done so as to clarify all its facets. This paper aims at enlightening some fundamental practical aspects of the CRM implementation. What are the practical aspects of the CRM implementation that are there? Implementation phase, options, what are the evolution? What are the critical success factors for the customer relationship management? And what are the benefits? The benefits of the knowing customer relationship management is important. By critically reviewing the related literature, the remainder of this paper is organized as follows. Section 2 presents the key phases of the typical CRM implementation process, and Section 3 identifies the three options a company has for adopting a CRM solution. Section 4 presents the main specification of evaluating a CRM project. Section 5 highlights the critical success factor for the CRM implementation, and the Section 6 presents the benefit that can be gained from a successful CRM implementation. Finally, in Section 7, some basic conclusions are drawn and the future direction are also highlighted as the regards of the CRM implementation. Hence, all the sections have been given and decided in this paper. CRM implementation process. This section presents the key phases that comprise a CRM implementation process. सीआरएम इम्प्लीमेंटेशन के जो जो फेजेज हैं वो आपको यहाँ पर आपको बताया गया है। ये पांच फेजेज हैं सीआरएम इम्प्लीमेंटेशन के, ये आपको यहाँ पर आपको बताया गया। डेवलप द सीआरएम स्ट्रेटजी, सीआरएम स्ट्रेटजी को डेवलप कीजिए। बिल्ड द सीआरएम प्रोजेक्ट फाउंडेशन, सीआरएम प्रोजेक्ट का फाउंडेशन क्या होगा उसको बिल्डअप कीजिए। स्पेसिफाई द नीड्स, नीड्स को आइडेंटिफाई कीजिए एंड सेलेक्ट द पार्टनर, व्हाट हु विल बी द पार्टनर। सिलेक्शन ऑफ द पार्टनर इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, बिकॉज इफ यू सेलेक्ट द बैड पार्टनर देन द योर बिजनेस विल बी गेट डिस्ट्रॉयड। हेंस द सिलेक्शन ऑफ द पार्टनर इज द मेन इंपॉर्टेंट इशू इन द केस ऑफ द सीआर। इंप्लीमेंट द प्रोजेक्ट, इंप्लीमेंट द प्रोजेक्ट एंड इवोल्यूएट द परफॉर्मेंस, इवोल्यूएट द परफॉर्मेंस। डेवलप द सीआरएम स्ट्रेटजी, डेवलप द सीआरएम स्ट्रेटजी। द मेन इंटरनल डिसीजन पॉइंट्स एंड एक्टिविटी एट दिस फेज आर एज फॉलो। सिचुएशन एनालिसिस, दिस एनालिसिस सेट आउट्स द to describe, understand and apprise the company's current customer strategy by specifying the customer related marketing and the sales objective, the customer acquisition and the retention strategy effectiveness. Customer acquisition, how to acquire the new customer, how to retain the customer, what are the strategy for retaining the customer. This is the important issue. The company's branding strategy, how to brand the company, the product portfolio, what are the product portfolio is there, the distribution channel and the more. Company ka branding strategy wo aapko zaruri hai, product portfolio aapko zaruri hai, distribution channel wo aapko zaruri hai. They are the decision points for the developing the CRM strategy. Commence the CRM education. Education enables people to alleviate any fears they might have as to what constitutes the CRM and increases participation from people that might be impacted. Develop the customer relationship management vision. The CRM vision shapes and directs the customer relationship management strategy. It might be senior management's perspective or it could be the product of a wider process involving more members, even customers and the partners. Set priority. Priority for action normally focused on cost reduction or enhanced customer experience. What will be the property, the priority of the business? It must be focused on the cost reduction. How to reduce the cost of the item, cost reducing strategy. Professor Dr. Manoj Kumar have written many of the paper on the cost reducing strategy. This is the most important in the case of the competitive environment. An enhanced customer experience must be set. Longer term priority might prove more difficult to implement. Establish goals and objectives. Goals, qualitative outcomes and the objective measurable outcomes emerge from the visioning and pivoting the activity. CRM goals generally cluster into the three broad areas. Enhancing the customer satisfaction, growing revenue or reducing the cost. Objectives created during this process will later serve to evaluate the CRM implementation. Identify people, process and technology requirement. Identify the people, identify the process and identify the technology requirement. As the project unfolds, the outcomes of this process are reviewed. Nonetheless, a general idea must be drawn in order to identify the associated cost. Identify the people. What are the people are the key person, identify the process, identify the technology requirement. What are the key processes are there? develop the business case. The business case is built around the cost and the benefits of the customer relationship implementation. Benefits such as more cross-selling and upselling, higher level of the customer satisfaction and retention, and the word of mouth influence must be assessed against cost, which may extend well beyond the cost of acquiring the CRM software to express incurred from system integration, new hardware, change management, training, and consultancy services. Most of the cost and benefits are measurable, but there are all strategic benefits that are harder to value, such as the improved customer service. This is to be given there. Build the CRM project foundation. The main internal decision points and activity at this stage are as follows. Identify the stakeholders. Stakeholders include any party impacted by the change, senior management, new system users, marketing staff, salespeople, and the IT space. Their participation in the project may be required at some point. The importance of the involving system users in the CRM implementation is reinforced by the Davis in the 1989, who concluded that the intention to use a new technology is protected by the perceived ease of use and the perceived usefulness of the technology. Early engagement of the users can help ensure that the technology is perceived by them as user-friendly and useful. The heart is giving this one. Identify the stakeholders. Number two, establish the governance structure. Governance structures need to be put in place to ensure that the project role and responsibility are properly defined and allocated. The program director must check that project deliveries are achieved and project costs are controlled. Another key member is the executive sponsor, who is typically a senior executive that ensures that the resources are always made available. The later stakeholders, together with the CEO, a sales executive, and the marketing executive, make the steering committee that is responsible for making policy decision, such at which consultant to hire. The PD is also a member of the program team that is made of the representative from the impacted area, AI sales, marketing, and the IT. The team is responsible for bringing in the right people for the specific activity. It is not uncommon for the CRM project to import external resources to help with the project delivery, such as a consultant and the system integrator. Identify the change management needs. What are the change will be there? CRM projects can prove challenging in terms of the change management is irrespective of their size. Kotler and the Cohen state that the sense of urgency should be created to pursue the people to change, that people should emotionally engaged, and that the supporting strategy must be built to remove the organizational barrier to change. Identify the project management needs. As with the every other project, a CRM project plan sets out the task and subtasks involved, their expected and the actual duration, the required resources, and the delivery. The project management role is generally performed by the program director. However, technology, it is outsourced to a consultant as the project progresses. There will be periodic milestone review that verify that it is on time and on budget. Wilson et al., 2002. Identify critical success factors. What are the critical success factors are there? Critical success factors are the attributes and variables that can significantly impact business outcomes. In the section 5 for in-depth analysis, will be given there the what are the critical success factors for the business. Number 6, develop the risk management plan. This is the very important. If there is a risk involved in the project, what are the plan to implement them? A large number of the CRM projects fail. A large number of the CRM project fail, that is given by the angle, but a very important point is there. many of the CRM projects are get built. At this stage, the major risks to successful CRM deployment are identified. The major risks to the successful CRM development are the identified. Once identified, risk mitigation strategy and contingency plans are put in place. The major risk to the successful CRM deployment are identified. Once identified, risk mitigation strategy and contingency plans put are in place. Specify the need and the select the partner. The main internal decision points and activity at this stage are as follows. Process mapping and the refinement. The first step of this phase involves categorizing and refining the business process. Examples of the business processes include the marketing, selling and innovation, and possible categorization are vertical, horizontal, and primary and the secondary process located entirely within a business unit. Horizontal process that are cross-functional. Primary process that have a major cost or the revenue implication. Secondary process with the minor implication. Examples of the business process include the marketing, selling, and innovation. Data review and the gap analysis. Having identified the processes that require attention, the next step is to review the data acquired for the CRM project and to create an inventory of the data available. Following that, the gap between what is needed and what is available must be specified, since the cost of developing and maintaining a customer-related database is quite substantial. A customer-related database is quite substantial. The gap between what is needed and what is available must be specified. This is given by the Johnson. Create an inventory of the data available. Data review and the gap analysis is important. Initial technology needs and the specification and research alternative solution. At this point, the stakeholders need to decide which technology will deliver the CRM mission and meet the business case requirements. They must also opt to build and the in-house application. Buy license software or outsource the implementation. Initial technology need a specification and research alternative solution. Write request for the proposal. Before calling for the proposal, a detailed request for the proposal must be written that summarizes the company's view of the customer relationship management program. Call for proposals. At this point, the potential partner are invited to respond to the request for the proposal. If the company already pays for the modules that will incorporate interoperate and the interconnect with the CRM system, their vendors will likely be added to the list. Revised technology needs and identification. Submitted proposals for the technology vendors will sometimes suggest improvement, modification, and enhancement on the customer relationship management requirement that the company may not have considered due to the lack of the expertise or the poor analysis. Assessment and the partner selection. This is the very important issue. If the wrong partner will be selected, then the business will be destroyed. The proposals are assessed and one or more partners are selected. This task is more commonly performed by an evaluation team that ranks the proposals after inviting vendors to demonstrate their solution in the relevant scenario or even provide the prototypes. Ranking is based on a weighted or the unweighted scoring system. Partner selection. Professor Dr. Manoj Kumar have various research paper on the partner selection, how the ranking is based on the weighted and unweighted scoring system. implement the project, the main internal decision points and activities that this stage are as follows. Refine project plan. Since the plan was originally defined without consideration of the needs and ability of the partners, at this point, it must be defined with the cooperation and contribution of the qualified vendors. Identify the technology customization needs. More often than not, of the sale technology fails to meet all the project requirements, and assuming a licensed solution has been chosen among the alternatives. Customization is often required. Customization needs are typically satisfied using the gap analysis for all the business process. The resultant gap register is asset priority are established and customization is carried out. Prototype, design, test, modify, and rollout. The result of the customization or the alternatively the in-house or outsourced implementation process is tested using either a duplicated or a dummy set of the data. Individual test will indicate if further adjustments are required, and if so, an iterative process takes place where improvements are realized and tested until the final version is ready to be deployed. Deployment usually takes place in a phase rollout to iron out any problem before company-wide adoption. Evaluate the performance. Evaluation of the performance is important. The main internal decision point and activity is this phase are the following. Project outcome. What are the project outcomes are there? What are the business outcomes? This part of the evaluation focuses on whether the project has been delivered on time and within budget. Delivered on time and within the budget. This is the most important point for the project outcomes. Business outcome. Evaluation of the business outcome requires from the steering committee and the program team to return to the project objective and the company specific definition of the CRM implementation success and verify that the desired goals have been attained. On and Patel, Kim and Kim and the Chan. Business outcome. Evaluation of the business outcome required from the steering committee and program team to return to the project objective and the company specific definition of the CRM implementation success and verify that the desired goals have been attained. Implementation option. Company may opt for any one or a combination of the following option for a CRM solution. Kumar and the Rent. Developing in-house software. Building an in-house customer relationship management solution requires defining all the requirements in paying for the R&D and the software development. Companies that choose this strategy must invest heavily in the third-party software and hardware, which add considerable to the overall cost. Moreover, the initial hardware and the software expenses constitute only a small portion of the total expenses, which are largely saved by the maintenance demand, especially those arising from the change request. The process can be carried out with the external consulting help, as the company may process the appropriate expertise to successfully carry out the task. Developing the in-house software. Buying the licensed CRM software. Even when company decide to buy a licensed CRM solution, they still need to develop their IT infrastructure and to integrate the new software with existing and the legacy application. The solution may be bought as a block or a quiet of the independent module. Although the CRM vendor will contractually be obliged to provide documentation and training for the new system, considerable effort still needs to be invested to acquire familiarity and skills to effectively run the solution. In addition, the company will occasionally need to go through the process of the upgrading the system with the new software release. Outsourcing the solution. In this case, the outsourcing company provides the hardware and the software. Implementation takes less time because the outsourcing company already has the necessary expertise, always the incentive to get the system running the soonest possible so that the service and the maintenance payment are initiated. Bowling it here. In this case, the outsourcing company provides the hardware and the software. Table 1 summarizes the advantage and disadvantage of each of the aforementioned three options. Advantage and disadvantage of the each CRM implementation option. Develop in-house software. This is the very important. Advantage, they develop a tailor-made solution adapted to their needs and structure. They develop internal resources and skills that allow them to update the system as requirements change. They avoid dependence on the CRM software vendors. They are not required to adapt their business practices to any particular software. These are the advantages. It is the most expensive and the time demanding implementation program. Buying the licensed CRM solution, most of the packages have a proven record of the success, so company can feel reassured and they will fit their needs. Apart from the initial fees and the licensing cost, company have to pay for the maintenance and upgrade over the life of the software. If the company chooses at the some point to customize the solution, it will have to pay for the external consulting service, which in general is quite expensive. Every major release will require training of the end user. Outsource the CRM development. The upfront costs are lower than in the other two approaches, as the company don't need to pay for the software license or to develop the internal IT skills to undertake the CRM implementation. Each time the company needs to adapt the solution to the new requirement, it has to pay the outsourcing company for the development. The company may initiate payments at the CRM results become visible, instead of the paying the upfront licensing and maintenance cost, suitable to a smaller firm that would otherwise be unable to afford a CRM program. Strong dependence to the outsource means that the company could risk losing the CRM investment if the outsourcer goes out of the business. CRM project evaluation. According to the several obtained reports, most of the CRM projects fail. In 2001, the failure rate of the CRM projects was estimated to be from 55% to the 75%. In addition, approximately 70% of the CRM projects results in either losses or no bottom line improvement in the company performance. A more recent survey conducted by the McKinsey Group in 2013 indicated that the CRM projects have a 63% failure rate. Very important point is given here by the Lovely. 63% of the failure rate of the CRM projects are there. At the same time, evaluating a CRM project is a complex process owing to its multidimensional nature. DIAC 2000 reported that the 90% of the 50 largest CRM users admitted they were unable to quantify a return on their CRM investment. The Giga Information Group found that only 30% of the company involved in the CRM deployment measured benefits. But how do firms actually come to a conclusion as far as the outcome of the CRM project implementation? In other words, how do they evaluate the process of adopting and implementing a CRM strategy? According to Battle, two sets of the variable can be measured: project outcomes and the business outcome. Project outcome focus on whether the project has been delivered on time within the budget. Evaluation of the business outcome, on the other hand, requires returning to the project objective, such as enhancing the customer retention rate or lead conversion by the sales team, and asking whether the desired results have been achieved. Most projects have several objectives, and it is quite common for some objectives to be achieved while others are not. The timing of the evaluation is a rather critical issue. as it can take several months for the enterprise to fully adopt the CRM strategy. Critical success factor for the CRM implementation. What are the critical success factors are there? This is the very important for any of the CRM, customer relationship management. Critical success factor is a term of for a characteristic condition or variable that is a vital impact of the company's mission. You have to check the company's mission. A variety of the factors determine significant success ingredient for successfully implementing CRM in the organization. Many researchers have attempted to develop a comprehensive list of the critical success factors. For in-depth analysis of the critical success factor, Finney and Corbett and Monjada et al. For in-depth analysis of the critical success factor, the success factors below are distilled from the extensive research on the CRM process. Top management, culture, human resource management, continuous improvement, knowledge management, technology, infrastructure. Top management. These factors refers to the degree of the top management involvement for the CRM project to be successful. The first step is to gain the support and commitment of the top management to the initiative. Explain the importance of the support from a senior management as being critical to their firm's ability to develop a customer knowledge competence. The top manager must demonstrate their support to the CRM program by involving themselves in the customer knowledge sharing the activity. Educating employee of the any level on the importance of the CRM, including CRM as part of the organizational vision and the mission. Moreover, since management support is critical factor for the successful innovation, CRM as an organizational innovation also requires management's strong impetus and the support. Another crucial role of the top manager is to eliminate constant such as a rigid regulation, hierarchical bureaucracy, lack of funding to the CRM program, close culture faced by the organization when deploying a CRM project. What budgeting of the resources, recruitment, and training of the employee and reward system is crucial for the CRM. Proper budgeting of resources, recruitment and training of the employee and reward system is crucial for the CRM. The CRM strategy should also be developed as a business strategy to confirm that CRM goals are in line with the strategy goals of the firm. Culture is the combination of the shared history, expectation, unwritten rules, and the social custom that compel the behavior. Relationship management requires a strategic change from a product or process-focused culture towards a customer-focused culture. Suggests that the nurturing the right culture is an important element in the CRM strategy implementation, particularly where the CRM strategy falls within the domains of the IT and the marketing, each of which contain their one organizational subculture. They argue that there is the positive relationship with the customer-oriented culture and the customer satisfaction. Thus, cultivating a customer-focused culture is essential for increasing the competitiveness of the company and achieving the customer objective. Human resource management. A wide variety of the professional, frontline sales, marketing, and the service provider, business analytics, IT professional, and the board area of the management must collaborate to ensure that the CRM strategy is the well-defined and delivered and the deployed. Delegating the responsibility and empowering staff to handle customer contacts is essential for the customer management. Unless employees are involved across all the stages of the implementation process, the strategy will be poorly understood. Furthermore, employees should be trained in the CRM system and other related technical tools in order to become sufficiently familiar with the CRM process concept. This can be achieved by improving the internal communication, promoting the cross-functional teams, and establishing a learning community. Training should focus on the developing skills and the competence in the communication, soft networking, peer learning, and the team building, market sensing, ability to understand customer, and creative thinking. Moreover, companies should aim to retain valuable employees by providing the opportunity for them to advance and rewarding them from their performance and the customer focused behavior. Continuous improvement. The benefit, performance, and problem of the CRM project should be measured, and then the necessary improvement should follow. Organization must find the right system of the measuring tangible and intangible results of the CRM to ensure that its objective are attained. Kumar et al. 2010 indicate that the organization must set measurable and specific relationship marketing objective and the key performance indicator such as retention rate, share of the wallet, and the customer lifetime value. This is the very important point given by the Kumar et al. Must set the measurable specific relationship marketing objective. Another important CRM evaluation mechanism is the benchmarking. Benchmarking is the process of the searching for the industry-wide practice that lead to the superior performance. And is very useful tool for the organization that have lower implementation level in some CRM practices. Knowledge management. According to the Jana Tritial, knowledge management is managing the corporation knowledge through a systematically and organizedly specified process for acquiring, organizing, sustaining, and applying, sharing, and renewing both the tactic and the expert knowledge of the employee to enhance organizational performance and create the value. Lane et al. 2006 defined the aspect of the customer knowledge management as the knowledge identify, knowledge capture, knowledge select, and the knowledge store. Knowledge sharing, knowledge application, knowledge creation, and the knowledge sale. Knowledge sale is important. Knowledge creation is important. Knowledge sharing is important. Knowledge capture is important. Knowledge select is important. This is the knowledge management. The management of the knowledge is increasingly considered as the main source of the competitive advantage for the corporation. The ability of the appropriate knowledge is an essential component for the development of the strategy, goods, and services, as well as distribution and communication channel. The two relationship management is said to be possible only when the knowledge management is integrated with data being transported in the knowledge. The ability of the large volumes of data on customer made possible by the new CRM technology tools has created opportunity as well as challenges for the business to leverage the data and gain competitive advantage. The importance of the knowledge management is highlighted by the Wilson. We identified it as a process that helps organizations find, select, and organize, dismantle, and transfer important information and expertise necessary for the activity. Some of the most knowledge sources are the markets, competition, customer, order, and contracts, product and services, problems, and the best practices. Technology infrastructure. Information technology and CRM are expected to provide the mechanism through which long-term individualized relationship with the customer can be created and maintained. The role of the information technology tools in the relationship management is to facilitate the different customer process, such as a rapid search, assess and retrieval of the customer information, segmentation of the customer based on their value, prediction of the customer behavior. In addition to help, it can support collaboration and communication between the organization's employee and the customer. Technical experts must be appointed to the CRM project team who are able to formulate how the different technology will be used, reviewing the existing architecture, infrastructure, and IT system applicable for the CRM project can help avoid unnecessary costs. Some of the IT technology framework and the tools that can support CRM are the intranet and the web portal, content management, search, and the information retrieval engines, business and intelligence, relational and object databases, groupware and the workflow system, data mining, electronic and the publishing system, data warehousing and the knowledge creation application. These are the technical infrastructure in there. CRM benefits. There are the many benefits of the implementation of the CRM. This section presents the benefit that can company get and could gain from a successful CRM implementation. Gray and Wen argued that the proper identification of the customer through clean data and the single customer view help Salesforce to facilitate the cross-selling. Furthermore, the understanding the customer through the differentiation can lead to the cost-effective marketing company. They suggest that the customer satisfaction and the loyalty through the interaction could also lead to the cost-effective customer service. Moreover, customer satisfaction and the loyalty through the personalization can help lower the cost of the acquisition and retention customer, thereby maximizing the share of the wallet. They summarize the main benefits of the CRM as follows. Improves the company's ability to retain and acquire customer. Maximize the lifetime value of the each customer. Improve service without increasing the cost of the service. Crosby argued that by using the customer information wisely to deliver what the customer needs, company will create long-term collaborative relationship with the customer. This will benefit organization in the further, since the long-term customers are the less costly to serve, the smooth running relationship are less resource intensive. Shift suggests that the organization can benefit from the CRM initiative in the following area. Higher customer retention and the loyalty. Customer retention will be increased when the customer stay longer, but more and by more frequently, the customer take more initiative that increase bonding relation. And the result, the customer loyalty increase. Increase customer profitability. The customer profitability will increase when the customer wallet share increases. The upselling goes up as well as the cross-selling and the follow-up sales and also more referral come with higher customer satisfaction among the existing customers. Evolution of the customer profitability. The organization gets to know which customer are profitable, potential profitable, and unlikely profitable. This is the key area as a successful business need to acquire and focus on those customers who bring profit. Reduce cost of the sale. The cost regarding selling decrease because existing customers tend to become more expensive. In addition, with the knowledge of the channels and distributor, the relationship become more effective and the cost for making the company are reduced. Lower cost of the recruiting the customer. When the cost of recruiting new customers are reduced, there will be saving to be made on the marketing, mailing, and the contact follow-up fulfillment service and the many more. No need to recruit so many customers to preserve a steady volume of the business. The number of the long-term customer will gradually increase. Consequently, the need to recruit many new customers will decrease. Jiang and Dokas found that an integrated CRM strategy would follow organization to manage customer and supplier relationship more efficiently. This could also help organization build long-term customer relationship, brand loyalty, and repeat sales, which could in turn result in the increased and sustained property. He also indicated that a successful CRM implementation could mean millions of the dollars in the incremental revenue from the increased customer retention, greater revenue per customer, and that with the ability to do cross-selling and upselling to customers, the result would be increased customer loyalty and the satisfaction. Thompson 2004 reported that in an online CRMG grew study of more than 1,000 CRM projects and enacted the top 4 expected benefits: increase in the customer loyalty, competitive advantage, sales and profitability. Increased productivity and cutting down in cost were also some of the expected benefits from the CRM initiative. The study concluded that the CRM activity and initiative have a positive impact on the company's overall performance. Wilson It here says that the CRM initiative help increase the individual customer margin as well acquire the right customer built on the formation and knowledge of the existing customer. Argue that the CRM strategy offer the following rates, benefits in the sale customer and the field service, increased marketing and the cross-selling opportunity. Identifying and targeting based customer based on the recent purchase, behavior and frequency of the monetary scoring. One-to-one marketing. Improve return on the marketing investment. Helps manage marketing company with the clear goals and the measurable or the quantifiable objective. Improve product development process due to the valuable knowledge gained from the direct interaction with the customer. Increase sales efficiency through wire and internet-based order entry. Better territory management with real-time account information updates. Improve telesales, field sales, and the sales management through the real-time information sharing among the multiple employees. Better revenue per call by focusing on growing the best accounts. Centralized customer contact from the sales support and field services and the marketing. Quicker problem resolution that ensures customer satisfaction, retention, and the loyalty. Such initiatives suggest that the integration of the customer data into a single database by an organization allows the marketing teams, Salesforce, and other departments within the company to share information and work toward the common corporate objective using the same underlying data. The ability of the particular data allows the firm to focus its time and resources on its most profitable customer. Classifying one's best customer this way allows an organization to manage them more efficiently as a premium group. With the understanding that is neither necessary nor advisable to treat all customers in the same manner. In addition, customer data can be analyzed for multiple perspectives to discover which elements of the marketing campaign produce the greatest impact on the sales and profitability. Finally, a number of researchers have attempted to quantify the benefits associated with the CRM solution. According to study by the ISM and the Insight Technology Group, a minimum 10% per annum increase in the gross sales revenue per sales representative and a minimum 5% decrease in the general and administrative cost of the sales are achievable during the first 3 years of the system. In addition, some retail banks have realized a 20% increase in the number of products sold per customer annually, an 83% decrease in the average customer information retrieval time, and 200% return on the technology investment through cost reduction over the 1 year. Future direction is important. Where the research can be done, this is the important for the students, for the BBA, MBA, MTech, PhD students, where the research can be done. CRM is primarily a strategy, not just a solution, and can provide enormous competitive advantage if successfully implemented. Now, with us, how we all the benefits associated with the CRM application, the literature shows that in situation where no effort have been shared to design the best possible system, these very system implies fail to deliver the expected result. At the same time, evaluating a CRM solution through imperative is also quite difficult since its positive impacts are diverse and affect many of the areas, each of which requires its own effectiveness metric. And this is the reason of the significant number of the CRM projects are eventually not evaluated. Despite the seemingly negative impact aspect of the activity, the CRM system, there are a number of the success stories within every business sector that demonstrate how the correct implementation and operation of the such application can enhance overall for performance. Assuming that the business case requirements are accurately defined, a CRM solution is expected to yield a substantial ROI and increase in the sales revenue per sales representative as well as the product sold to the customer, and decrease in the matrices such as the total cost of the sales and customer information retrieval time. More, the system can serve as a continuous improvement tool that helps the enterprise not only standardize the sales-related customer-facing business process, but also identify weaknesses, calibrate and update existing procedure, eliminate redundancy, and possibly introduce the new activity by leveraging and analyzing the data being recorded, thereby achieving the process optimization. company are also expected to achieve intangible benefit such as a smoother cross-functional operation and increased employee and customer satisfaction and improved image. Owing to the various technology advances, a dramatic change in the CRM landscape is expected in the future. The currently growing trends of the CRM and social CRM, global CRM and cloud computing, social web has been focal point for the growth of the social CRM. Blog social networking platform like the Facebook mobile application and consumer-to-consumer interaction are heavily exploited, having a clear impact on the business to customer B2C world. Global CRM, on the other hand, is the application of the CRM process and practices such as a software by firm operating in the multiple country. Finally, the development of the cloud computing as the fastest growing method for the data storing provides a unique advantage of the CRM, in that the previous physical and the organizational structure no longer exist. It should be stressed that the advancement in the CRM have given rise to issues and concerns such as identity theft and privacy right violation. Kumar and Rache for an in-depth discussion. No, nonetheless, CRM unruly remains a valuable platform for developing a competitive advantage. References are given here. Aldwani, Anderson, Ang and Battle, Anton and Petov, Baran and Galka, Burchett and Habji, Bowling and Wardman, Battle, Chang, Park and Chen and Popchip, Crosby, Davis, Dong, Daiche, Erickson, Finne, Fuhon Na, and the Galbraith and Rogers. Galbraith, Goodhue, Gray and Van, Gulati and the Gano, Hellinger, Hart and Hogue, Intra, Rewet, Iyer, Genex, Jiang, Johnson, Kim and Potter, Kumar and the Range. Customer relationship management, concept, strategy, and the tools. Kumar, Oslo and the Donkers, La Valle, Libusi, Lean, Landgren, Mac, Macklin, Mendoza, Okrand, Uyu, Pan, Chatvier, Peel, and Pepsin, Rabat, Rivers, Saloon, Seaman, Sackard, Stalu, Swift, Thompson, Tim, Wang, Wantable, and the Wilson. Ju, Jablab, and the Jerry. Many of the references are given here. In this research paper. And today we have discussed about the different references of the customer relationship management. What are the future directions of the customer relationship management? What are the customer relationship management benefits? What are the benefits of the customer relationship management? Critical success factors for the customer relationship implementation. What are the critical success factors are there? CRM project evaluation. Here it is given that the many of the CRM projects get failed. CRM projects have a 63% failure rate, LAVLA 2030. Implementation option. Implementation. CRM implementation process. What are the different CRM implementation process are there? Introduction of the customer relationship management. Abstract of the customer relationship management, a literature review and the future direction that is given in the case of the customer relationship management.